All right, I'm going to jump over to talk to my expert down in Florida. If you're hanging on the line, hopefully you're enjoying the show and you can stay with us. But I want to get over to my buddy Craig Beggins from Century 21 Beggins in Tampa, St. Petersburg. How you doing, Craig?
Hey, Greg. Very good. How are you?
Good, good. Thank you. How's the weather? Is it 99 or 104 down there right now?
Actually, about 95, but I just finished the boat tour with some customers from Michigan.
Okay.
Fell in love.
All right. We'll talk more about the boat tour in a few minutes. I think what you do with that is great. You show people the view of Tampa St. Pete from the bay and from the water side, which I think is really cool. So a little bit of setup. Craig Beggins is a member of the Own America Network. What we have right now is we're rapidly building a national network of real estate professionals and real estate companies who really know the investment side of real estate and can help to unlock this this massive amount of capital that I believe is out there waiting to come into the American housing market if they feel comfortable with the markets they're going into and if, like Maggie just said, they feel comfortable with the professionals they're working with at the street level. So Tampa St. Pete, I was down there with Craig. He runs one, he owns and operates one of the biggest Century 21 real estate companies in the world. Occupies and dominates that entire coast there in Tampa, St. Petersburg, and the surrounding area. And what I always do in this situation, Craig, is I put on my blog some basic data that I want listeners, if they're home in front of a computer, they can do this, or if they're in the car, you're going to want to do this later. But what I've done is I first look at what the heck is going on. Okay, look at a couple of charts and graphs to give me a sense of the facts of what's happening, and then I want to talk to an expert to tell me why it's going on. So I'm staring right now at a chart of the Tampa area home values over the last 10 years. And you and I have already talked about this. It looks like the top of like Mount Kilimanjaro, okay? It goes straight up from 2001 all the way to 2006. It peaks in about 2007, and then it comes practically straight down. And so you're sitting there right now with home prices that are darn similar to what they were back in 2001, right?
Absolutely.
So what caused that meteoric rise and then that meteoric fall in home prices, in your opinion?
You know, Greg, we have a difference between investors and speculators, and really I blame speculators for that rise. We had so much going for us at the time that people would buy without the intent to hold for a long term, and they just kept buying and flipping, and we raised prices so high it was unnatural.
Okay, so I'd love to hear that from the standpoint of you look at what happened between 2003 and 2006 as the anomaly,
absolutely,
right? That was the thing that didn't belong. Home prices in Florida have been steadily growing as the population grows, as the job base grows. And then when they kind of went off like a ski jump at the end of that nice gradual curve, that was something that could not sustain itself. And now we've come down, but I think we've come down too far. Are you seeing that sentiment in the marketplace?
No question about it. When you can buy a house for less than it costs to build and you get the premium land for free, there's a problem.
Yeah, it's a problem, and then there's a huge opportunity.
So
if I scroll a little bit further down on my blog, I also have this chart that you and I have spoken about, which is the migration patterns in Hillsborough County, which is where Tampa is. And we see a massive amount of migration still coming into your county, and it's coming in from all the major population centers in the Northeast in a very big way. But it's interesting. It's also coming from Miami, Naples, Fort Lauderdale, Palm Beach. What's happening where you are that's drawing Floridians to come across the state and come to you?
Yeah, it's interesting, Greg, but you know, Florida is considered a waterfront state, although we don't have a whole lot of waterfront. But if you go anywhere around the state of Florida, the waterfront is very expensive. But when you come to Hillsborough County or Pinellas County, we have offices in Pinellas too, the waterfront is drastically undervalued compared to waterfront areas elsewhere. So I think when you're comparing Miami and Fort Lauderdale or even Naples, they're looking at, you know, land that a house is $3 million in Naples, so you can buy a house here for a third that price. That's a comparable building.
Interesting. So you're competing with other parts of Florida. Hey, Craig, hang on. We're going into a break now, but I want to keep this going. This is Greg Rand. You're listening to Rand on Real Estate. We're going to be back in a minute talking more about the west coast of Florida. Hang on with us. All right, welcome back to Rand on Real Estate. A little Led Zeppelin there for you. Love the bumper music today, Mike.
Love it.
All right, so we're talking about Tampa and St. Petersburg with Craig Beggins of Century 21 Beggins. That's c21beggins.com, right, Craig?
Correct.
All right, so people who want to find you can find you there. We were just talking about how it's really interesting. If you look at the migration chart that I put on my blog at ownamerica.com, you can see people are coming to your market from other parts of South Florida, which is cool because the entire state is on sale right now, and the fact that you've got that advantage where you're actually pulling people, there's got to be something else going on in terms of jobs and lifestyle that makes this Tampa-St. Pete area a choice that other Floridians are making. So can you give me kind of a flavor of the culture down there and the job situation?
You know, it's funny, Greg, since I've been involved with your program, I've been training my agents on this. And we actually listened to a radio show that you did in about Fort Myers market. And I asked the agents, I said, what's the difference about the Tampa market over Fort Myers? And we went through the marketplace and said, you know, are we an agricultural economy? And the answer is yes. We have a strong agricultural base. Plant City is one of the biggest producers of strawberries in the country. But we're not dependent on strawberries or any other agriculture for that point. Do we have a military installation? Yes. We have MacDill Air Force Base, which is home of CENTCOM, which controls all the Middle East operations of the United States Marine Forces or the Armed Forces. But we're not dependent on military. We've got a huge corporate base. We've got a beautiful downtown. We've got a beautiful interstate structure. We've got, just you name it, we've got tourist attractions. We have Busch Gardens. We have beautiful beaches. We have a whole bunch of different economic factors driving our market, but we're not dependent on any one of them.
That's interesting. That's huge. You know, being a New Yorker outside the New York area, I've always seen how one of the big advantages of our metro area is that there's no one industry that can go sideways. Even when Wall Street goes sideways, which is such a major economic driver here in New York, it's so diverse in terms of the number of companies that are here. And you've got kind of a microcosm of that down there. You've got the shipping, you've got the agriculture, you've got all these different pieces, and you're not dependent on any one of them, which means it's just more robust, right?
I think so.
And it's also kind of laid back. I got a vibe down there that's a little bit, there's a little, I don't know, is it a little slice of Key West going on down there? Is that what I'm sensing?
Yeah, definitely. I moved from Miami, and Miami is definitely more fast-paced. The west coast of Florida is definitely more laid back, easier going, not as much hustle and bustle.
Yeah, it's interesting. Hey, you know what, Craig, we have a good opportunity here. We have Mike from Holtsville who's called in, who has questions about some things about St. Petersburg, Florida. So let's bring Mike into the conversation. How you doing, Mike?
I'm doing great, Craig.
Well, thanks for calling and thanks for holding. We got Craig Beggins here. So you called about St. Petersburg.
That's
I've got
right,
you
Craig,
an expert.
Thanks for taking my call today. You got a great show.
Thank you. I appreciate it. So what's on your mind?
Well, I'm calling. I've been going down to Tampa St. Pete now for about 10 years because I go to spring training to see the Yankees. I spent about 2 or 3 weeks catching some games, and I just love the area. And what I'm trying to do is to buy an owner finance property because I don't think my credit is credit worthy right now to get a mortgage. But I do have sufficient cash flow. I have my own business. What I'd like to do is be able to purchase something with just maybe a 5 to 7 year mortgage. What's the best way that I can attract a homeowner like that?
Interesting question. Craig, you want to handle that one?
Well, I'll give it a stab. Your name was it Joe?
Mike.
No, Mike.
Mike. Mike, you got an interesting challenge because you said your credit is what's keeping you from being financed by a seller, by a bank.
Mm-hmm.
You're really dealing with a smaller pool of properties. You know, not everybody's going to be willing to sell to you. Not saying that nobody will be, because certainly somebody will. I think I would first put together, just like you were applying to a bank, you're going to need to show a seller your true intentions and your ability to repay. And then you're really going to need a good real estate agent to represent you. To say, look,
well, absolutely. I believe in that. I've been a realtor for 20 years.
Okay.
So, you know, so let me jump in here a second. One of the things about this also is that you do have one advantage, Mike, in that there are people trying to sell properties that can't, right? Now, in the case, down in your marketplace, I know things are starting to heat up down there. I know prices are stabilizing. I know sales, Craig, year over year are way up compared to 2010.
Yes.
Are you seeing inventory burning off quickly, or do you still see people that own homes and condos that are struggling to unload them right now?
Oh, definitely. I mean, Greg, we're down from 21,000 units in the greater Tampa MLS to just over 10,000 units today from 2007 to today. So our inventory has declined 50%. At the same time, our sales have gone from, 900 units a month to over 2,000 units a month. Our inventory supply has gone from 21 months down to 5.8 months. So things are correcting down here.
Okay, so it's not exactly an ideal time to go to people who are trying to sell properties and say, hey, I've got an opportunity for you, but you have to hold financing for it.
No, but at the same time, I've got to say that there's a lot of people that have been holding on too long. You know, we've got a big percentage of distressed properties, short sales. Property values dropped so far that some people need to sell, but they can't afford to sell because they owe too much. Mike's
right.
Interesting. He said on a 5 to 7 year note, that would be a very interesting payment. because that would be a much higher payment than somebody would be making on a normal term loan from a bank. He might be able to find a seller who's been holding on that can't sell because he owes too much. He might be able to owner finance and still make his mortgage payment because Mike was able to pay more monthly than his mortgage is.
Well, they also might find having somebody to pay 6 or 7% interest rather than what they're getting from a bank, probably something good on an installment plan also.
Sure. Okay. So you know what? What I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you, Mike, to give your number to the people here that have put you on hold, and we'll put you in touch with Craig and see if we can find a solution. And if we can, we'll revisit this in a future show and show how, you know, we're all about solutions here. So, Mike, I appreciate your call very much. Thanks for waiting on hold with us, and have a great day.
Thanks, Mike.
All right. So, Craig, tell me more about, you were starting to say that the job situation down there was strong. Are you seeing companies expanding or companies moving there now?
You know, we're still feeling the national pressures of unemployment.
Okay.
But locally, Tampa, if you read the newspaper every day, there's always a new company moving in because our housing is so cheap, our cost of living is so good, and our environment is so great to live in. So I think the Tampa market, I really don't know offhand. I'd have to look at the stats. But I would say we're probably a little bit ahead of the national curve on recovery on unemployment.
All right, sounds good. And one of the things that really struck me when I was down there is that, give me an example of a three-bedroom house in one of your more high-value, affordable communities there. Well, price-wise, and what you could rent it for.
Big difference. We have five offices in our marketplace. From Hillsborough County, which is the big market, the base land, then we have the Gulf Beaches, which is right against the Gulf of Mexico. Huge price disparity between the two.
So give me the ones that are inland. Give me the ones that are, I mean, there are some numbers there that I know are going to pop the people's...
Oh, it's going to scare you. Homes that were selling in 2005, which was, what, 6 years ago, for $220,000, $230,000 for a 1,600-square-foot, brand-new at the time, three-bedroom, two-bath, 1,600-square-foot house, are selling today as a short sale or a foreclosure. Are you sitting down?
Yeah.
$90,000.
$90,000, yeah. And there are even some places. When we were there, you talked to me about a two-bedroom villa, detached villa, that was on the market for $38,000.
Oh, we got one. I'm a Fannie Mae broker as well. We just got one from Fannie Mae. $18,000.
$18,000. And what could that rent for?
That house, that's a one-bedroom, one-bath condo in a deed-restricted community with full amenities. That house would rent for probably $600 or $700 a month.
All right. So if you bought a house for under $20,000 and rented it for $600 or $700 a month, you're talking about a 15% or 18% return on your money, and you got the potential for that house that's selling for a ridiculously low number to make its way back to $75,000, $80,000, $90,000, $100,000 in value over the next 10 years. And folks, that is what we're talking about on this show, and that's why we bring you to places like Tampa and St. Pete and introduce you to people like Craig Beggins, because when you're here in the Northeast and you hear, I mean, $20,000 is the tax bill on a house in most neighborhoods where people are listening to from.
Yeah, you can't finance those. You got to pay cash. The banks don't want to lend money on those little purchases.
Right. So you use your down payment, and the whole thing is a down payment because it's only $20,000. So anyway, this is why we want to bring this to the attention of people up here, because Florida, there's a place in our heart for Florida here in the New York area. And when you start looking at, come off the coast by a few miles, start seeing the kind of values that you can get, and the fact that there's a robust job market, a lot of migration coming into the area, and people want to rent properties right now because they're losing their homes to foreclosure, what you have is a recipe for a gold mine later on when the market revives. So, Craig, thank you very much for being on the air with us. That's Craig Beggins from Century 21 Beggins, c21beggins.com. Really appreciate your time.
My pleasure. Thanks, Craig.
All right, thank you. All right, you're listening to Rand on Real Estate. We're going to go back to a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about Atlanta. And don't forget to give me your calls. We have time for a few more calls. The number here is 800-848-WABC. That's 800-848-9222. Back in a moment.